Welcome back. Here's our stunning spider, one of Italy's finest ever drop tops. We've got a budget of up to $4,000 to buy and restore it. With a gleaming new paint job, it won't be long now before I can sell it on, hopefully for a big profit.
Now I've got our spider back to my workshop, I can truly see quite how good Dick's work is. I mean, this fantastic, passionate, racing red really suits this car, but it can look better. In fact, it will look better once I've bolted back on all those lovely, shiny bits.
I'm making sure I don't damage the paintwork. I'm using these cloths to rest the bright work on while I do the fitting. We certainly don't want any scratches. The chrome really sets off the red bodywork and gives the car a real feeling of glamour. I remembered to carefully store away all those one-off fixings. Many a restoration has been held up waiting for hard-to-source parts to arrive from an Italian importer. I'm giving the chrome a good clean while it's off the car. It's much easier to get into all the nooks and crannies then. Warm soapy water and then specialist metal polish does the trick every time. The Alfa is really coming together, but I've still got to tackle those headlights, so once this trademark grille is on, that's my next job.
These are the headlight pods from our Alfa Romeo. Now, it's a left-hand drive car made in Italy. Of course, like Europe and the rest of the world, basically, they all drive on the right-hand side of the road. And so these headlights are designed to shine ever so slightly to the right-hand side of that road to stop dazzling oncoming traffic. Now, that's fine over there, but of course, over here in Britain, we're a little bit special. We drive on the left, which means these headlights are now throwing light into oncoming traffic. Now, the way to fix it properly is to use a new sealed beam unit. Now, these ones are designed for British roads. We drive on the left, therefore, this light mostly points over to the left, which makes it perfectly safe to drive, and I can actually tell that that's right, a little arrow on the bottom of the lens. So once I've replaced the old lights with these ones, then our Alfa will be ready for the open road, in Britain at least.
These replacement headlights are still in production, but you'll have to find a specialist Alfa supplier. I've got the spider on the ramp and removed the front wheel for access. I roughly fit the new unit and then comes the clever bit.
My headlamps are now in position, but they may well not be in the right alignment, and that's very important I get that right. Now, traditionally, if you're in your own little garage, what you do is you park your car against a nice flat wall, shine your lights on it and get them roughly right, then maybe take it down to the garage and get them to give you a hand to get them exactly in position. If, on the other hand, you're lucky enough to have a beam setter, you can do it accurately at home. Now, what you have to do first of all, I've got the beam setter centered on the headlamp. I've got my lights on and I can look now. Basically, the beam from the headlamp is shined into a lens and that in turn gets projected onto a little chart. And I can see straight away that actually my headlamp is pointing too low and also too far over to oncoming traffic.
No worries, I'll adjust the headlamp position with the locating screws and recheck the chart on the beam setter. It confirms that the calibration is now perfect.
Our Alfa Romeo is finito. OK, so there weren't too many jobs to do, but it was really hard work, and if it hadn't been for the help of Dick down at the body shop, we certainly wouldn't be looking at this triumph of Italian style. I can now say proudly that when this car drives down the road, we won't be getting embarrassed looks, but stares of admiration.
Spider is a really glamorous ragtop. Ed has rolled back the years and revealed a head-turning classic that'll be happy cruising the B roads for many years to come. I found this car through an ad in a local paper, and I got lucky when I paid £2,200 for it. But it did have a few problems. Then again, it wouldn't be Wheeler Dealers without Ed wielding the spanners, would it? First job was to make sure this lovely raspy engine runs smoothly by changing the manifold couplings. Next, he got down on his hands and knees to weld up a hole in the footwell. With the car watertight, it was time to strip off all the shiny bits, rub down the body and fill in an unsightly dent on its nose. The front end paint job is perfect, you can't even see the join. And from there, it was just a case of a few finishing details, like polishing up the chrome and fitting new UK headlights. Che bella. How much did we spend? Well, the rubber manifold couplings were £47. The welding cost nothing. The dent was sorted with a £5 tub of filler. But then came the big bill, £835 for a respray, worth every penny. And the new headlights were only £38. The car originally cost £2,200. So our grand total is £3,125.
Wow. Wow.
Ed.
You've done it again, haven't you? I'm speechless, Ed. We got a proper red Italian sports car. And it looks like the paintwork is fantastic. Last time I saw it, I had that nasty blue bonnet. It was all prepared for paint, but now it looks brilliant.
Basically, we've got this fantastic new coat of red paint, so it looks great during the day, but also looks really good at night because I fixed the headlights. You can see where you're going.
Fantastic, because it had the left-hand drive headlamps on. That's right. Was blinding people. So now they've been converted to the UK road.
Exactly.
Brilliant. OK, well, I can't wait to get this thing out on the road. Give me the keys. Now, the engine in this car is a real cracker. It's got that lovely little raspy exhaust note, perfect for those summer days when you got the top down and you can hear what's going on behind you. It says, get me out on the open road, get the wind in the hair and enjoy motoring. Now, Ed really had his work cut out on this car. He had to do the welding on the floor. We had the other jobs to do, like the awful paintwork and the damage at the front. And he's carried that off. I know he had the help of Dick, but it's all in the preparation. And the way it's turned out, I can't contain my excitement. It looks fan-blooming-tastic, this car. Ciao, Bella. Ciao. Easy.
Click here to subscribe.